It was too late. The bandits had caught the scent of the beast and were presently attempting to waylay him when he led them deep into the wilderness. He had the advantage in this place, but like all apex predators, he knew when to avoid unnecessary fights.
An intruder comes among us!
He watched hidden from his perch as the bandits ran haplessly through his stomping ground.
He cannot stand against us!
He's gone this way!
Shouted one of their ranks from underfoot. And the beast let them pass. Then came a rumbling from the forest path. A lone rider. The beast shot his gaze towards the wayward traveler. Fool, he thought. Damn fool. This was not what the beast had in mind. The boy needs to leave. But the boy sensed no danger in the forest. And who should this handsome traveler be but the woodcutter from the day before? The woodcutter was in search of good wood when he came upon an open field where the bandits watched hidden from sight. Then all at once those fearsome bandits descended upon the woodcutter with a terrible fury. The woodcutter drew his blade as the bandits blocked his exit. The fight was all but forced.
My armor is proof against the light of thee.
Fear thou thy fate?
Ah! Hello, lad.
Ah! The villain staggered.
My attempts shall avail you not. Ah! Give in to thy pain. Thou dost only prolong thy fate.
Only then did the beast enter the fray. The beast battled with a mesmerizing violence, but the woodcutter showed no fear. While the bandits retreated to lick their wounds, the woodcutter stood his ground. He locked eyes with the wild man. He was transfixed by the majesty of the beast, compelled by his animal magnetism. He strode confidently towards his savior.
So you're the one they're searching for?
The beast stared without betraying recognition.
Rare, to find a man who can still fight. Rarer yet, to find a man who can still win.
The woodcutter offered his hand in fellowship, but the beast paid no mind to the gestures of men. His gaze blank, like a lame mare's. The beast began to back away. The woodcutter could only ponder what lay beyond those steely eyes, such power on display with that beefy, beastly body.